Hello guys, welcome to Mercedes-Benz King. This is the all-new Mercedes-Benz S-Class, and in today's video I will show you the full driving characteristics of the S500. It also has the rear axle steering. So in this video I will show you how it maneuvers around in the city. I will also show you all new technology, this portrait screen, the 3D picture in front of us, and also the augmented reality in the head-up display, as well as here on the display. It has a very luxurious color, the entrance seat blau or entrance seat blue, and it has the AMG package, also a lot of warning systems. The interior doesn't have the flat bottom AMG steering wheel because it has a gorgeous and luxurious wood option, and then you can't have the flat bottom. You can also see the wood on the side door panel and the dashboard. Amazing. So let's have a look at the exterior. This entrance seat blue exterior color looks actually very grayish and blackish from different angles. Also, this particular S-Class has a special option on its option list. You can see that the window is a little bit bluish, and this is to block the UV lights from the sun. Very special, and also here in the front. Let's first admire the total length, because it has been increased with a few centimeters. Right now it is 5 meters and 30, or actually 28 centimeters long for the long wheelbase. So I've got the key right here. This is not only the all new Mercedes-Benz S-Class key, but also the new Mercedes-Benz design, which we also see in the new C-Class. So let's lock the S-Class, and we will unlock it again. And now we will have a look at the front, because it has the all new Mercedes-Benz design, especially noticeable by the headlights, because the three dots indicate that this is the king of the road, the S-Class. The E-Class has two dots, and the all new C-Class, as you could see from my Instagram and my all new C-Class video, it has only one dot. Furthermore, an amazing Mercedes star on the hood, and this is especially only for S-Class, the E-Class facelift, and the Maybach GLS. And each LED has actually 1.3 million pixels, so you can reach up to 650 meters in front of you, and that's just amazing. Again, I love this entrance seat blue exterior color, and this is the AMG line, so very aggressive front bumpers. It also has a larger radiator grille in a reverse A shape, so it used to be an A shape, but now the reverse. So let's move over into the side, where you can notice these lovely blacked out rims, and this is actually part of the winter tires. So normally you can have even more aggressive and luxurious rims for your winter. It has amazing chrome elements, contours around the window, with the chrome side spoiler on the side. So let's open the door, and you will see how massive and long these doors are, with amazing luxury inside. The door also closes on each point where you would just leave it. So let's have a look inside. So let's close the door. Soft closing doors, of course. And as you can see, I'm already sitting very relaxed in the back seats. And you might think this seat is a little bit too far at my knees. And that's because the passenger in front of me was also driving very relaxed. But you have this button so that you can press the lounge. You don't have to press and hold it, and in this way the seat moves forward and you get a maximum amount of space. You can see that the headrest moves forward, and now my seat starts to move. I can feel that the back moves backwards, the seat itself moves a little bit forwards, and there the leg extensions appear. I will press the upright standing position, Now the seat in front of me simultaneously moves into position. And now I'm sitting really upright. And I will press the button for the infotainment system to start. And you can immediately see a lot of screens. In front of me, my passenger, and also a third one at the center console. And this exactly mimics the screen in front of me. So if I press the home button, it will show it right here. You can have a look at the navigation.
In 100 meters, turn right and then immediately turn right.
My current location. It has the sensors which warn you for pedestrians or cyclists. So let's press the settings. Over here you have your roller sunblindings. So you can take the roller down. And also the side roller in the rear. Put it up. And you can even open and close the panoramic roof. Roller sunblindings. And as you can see, it also has the Burmester surround sound system in a very large stereo over here. Amazing. So let's put it back, because otherwise it's way too dark in here. So let's put this device back into position. And as you lay it down, it sucks it up. And over here you have some more storage space. And actually two table private jet style. And this way you can work, put your laptop on it, or even eat. It also has it for the passenger in the rear. And you can also then close this, and here it has the ambient lighting around it. It looks amazing in dark. So I will also show you a night drive video. Very luxurious. Behind this wooden box, a fridge. So let's put it back into position. And over here you have also a wireless charging pad for your phone. And a lot more in the front. So guys, let's take the S-Class for a drive. And I will show you the driving characteristics in the city, but also on the Autobahn. A very easy exit because of a little bit higher seating position. Soft closing doors, of course. So guys, make sure you follow me on Instagram, the link is down below. And I have amazing content special for you about all new Mercedes-Benz vehicles. So guys, let's take the S-Class for a drive. I will close the door. Soft closing doors, of course. And let's press the button for the electronics to work. It already says Mercedes-Benz. And as we hear the music, the surround sound system of Burmester flips out. And as we decrease the music and turn it off, it will flip back into position. Amazing. But I will activate it a little bit so that it is turned outside. And you can adjust the seats with these seat adjustments on the side. And you don't really feel that you're pressing the button. It is an interactive touch system. It also looks kind of like a display on the side, and you will also see this on the C-Class. And the first thing that catches my attention is the quality in the interior. Of course, it has the optional wood, so on the door panel, the dash, and also on the steering wheel. And this means it feels very firm, also with a lot of leather stitching and perforation on the seats. Over here it has this portrait style screen. So let's press the button for the engine to start. And you can't hear anything. You do feel that the 3-liter six-cylinder engine starts. So as I told you, currently we are in Zurich city. Let's take a right turn over here. And with the rear axle steering, it feels very easy cornering. On theory, just like an A-Class, because it reduces the turning radius with 2 meters. And I love this engine, the 3-liter six-cylinder of the S500. It has a staggering 435 horsepower. So that means a top speed of 250 kilometers an hour, of course limited. But it feels very fast and also a nice sound on the background. And as we approach an ampoule or a traffic light, this camera will appear. This is the augmented reality on the navigation system screen. In this way, it is easier to see whether the light turns green. And the pixels are very crisp and clear. Brabus. So let's accelerate a little in comfort mode and let's listen. It sounds very comfortable. And it has no problem with accelerating. I will just close the panoramic roof because it is tilted. And in this way you can enjoy the absolute silence. It also has double glass for the windows. It's also called the acoustic glass, but this you can really see it has two separate glass for a window. So right here on the screen you can touch the home button, and it also has haptic feedback, so you can really feel when you're pressing the buttons. And as you increase or decrease the temperature, the lights will appear. So you can see here the red and blue lights. Amazing. So let's press the vehicle settings. And talking about AR, in front of me I also have an arrow that tells you exactly where you need to go. It can move into the street and it can reach up to 40 meters in front of you. And that is also a reason why the gap for the head-up display is also so large. So guys, now it is time to have a look at what is under the bonnet. And you have to pull it two times for it to release correctly. So you don't have to press any buttons. You can just pull it up and there's no safety anymore, only at the door side. So this is the S500 4MATIC. It has a 435 horsepower engine, 3-liter six-cylinder. And it also has the EQ boost with an additional 22 horsepower at go. So from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in just 4.6 seconds. And the top speed is 250 kilometers an hour, limited of course. So let's close the bonnet. And we will lastly check out what is in the trunk. Because this is the S-Class long wheelbase. And it has an immense trunk. Also an additional pillow, very deep, around 800 liters of trunk capacity. So let's close the trunk. And guys, thanks for watching Mercedes-Benz King. I hope you liked this video with the all new generation S-Class, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.